In this video, we'll look at a compound interest example, and we'll solve it with BAII Plus Financial Calculator. AJ invested $6,000 6 years ago, which earned 4.5% compounded monthly for the first 2 years. After that, the interest rate was changed to 5% compounded quarterly. The question is, what is the maturity value of his investment today, and the amount of interest earned so far? In this problem, we're looking at 6 years term in total. The interest rate changed after 2 years. We need to consider two time segments, the first 2 years and the last 4 years. As a result, we'll have two steps of calculations. Step one, we'll calculate the future value at the end of the second year. Step 2, looking at the second time segment, future value from the first time segment becomes PV here. We'll then calculate the future value, which is also the maturity value of the investment after 6 years. We'll solve the problem with BAII Plus Financial Calculator. Let's look at the calculation steps. There are 7 variables involved with compound interest calculations. PY, number of payment per year. CY, number of compounding periods per year. N, number of compounding periods. IY, interest rate. PV, present value. PMT, periodic payment. FV, future value. The interest rate is 4.5% compounded monthly. Therefore, IY is 4.5 and CY is 12. Present value is $6,000. Please note, PV and FV are always in opposite signs, representing cash inflow and outflow. Let's make PV negative here. Considering investment is a cash outflow, then we'll be expecting a positive future value. PMT refers to periodic payment, such as monthly payments for mortgages or credit cards. There's no periodic amount involved in this example. Therefore, PMT is zero. Since PMT is zero and there's no periodic payment, in such case, PY, number of payments per year, will take the same value as CY, which is 12. N is the total number of compounding periods. The term is 2 years, compounding 12 times a year. N is 2 times 12, which is 24. With all this information, we'll be able to calculate future value for the first step. In the second step, PV would be the same value as the first future value calculated. We are looking at the last 4 years. Interest rate has changed to be 5% compounded quarterly. So IY is 5 and CY is 4. PMT is still 0. There's no periodic payment. And PY is the same as CY, which is 4. And the total number of compounding period is 4 years times 4 times per year, total 16. Now we're ready to use financial calculator to finish the calculation. Push the on-off button to turn on the calculator. We'll clear memory from previous calculations by pushing the buttons second and clear TVM. This step is not required since we could also override all the old data by entering new data. In order to enter PY and CY, we'll push the buttons second and PY. PY is 12, push 12 and then enter. Scroll down, we can change CY here. By default, CY is the same value as PY. Exit by pushing second and quit. Next, we'll be using these 5 keys, N, IY, PV, PMT, and FV. If you enter any 4 values, you'll be able to calculate the remaining one. In this first step, we have 24 for N, 4.5 for IY, 6,000, make it negative for PV, 0 for PMT. Compute future value. We have 6563.940706. We'll keep all the decimals in this middle step. This future value is also the PV for the next calculations. So make it PV. Now let's go back, change PY and CY by go to second PY. PY is 4, 4 enter, scroll down, CY is also 4. Second quit, 16 for N, 5 for IY, PV has been already entered, 0 for PMT, compute future value. This time we'll round it to two decimals. Future value is $8,007.28. So that is the maturity value after 6 years of investment. And the amount of interest earned over the 6 years is the future value take away the initial investment amount, which is $2,007.28. That solved the problem. Thank you for watching.